Hi there, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. I am Nails, and this is the Year of the Guitar. So I'm coming to you today to give you an update on where we're at with my great guitar build, the River Styx. It's an entry into the kit build, and it started out as an Esteban Midnight Legacy guitar that I purchased from a pawn shop. So it's entirely prefabricated. I took it apart. I pulled off all the finish in the last video, and man, that is not my favorite process at all. It's like sanding times 10, except you use a heat gun too. It's kind of the worst. It's questionable whether or not it's worth the difference in a price between modifying an existing guitar and building a kit. Anyway, so where we left off was I had routed out a river-ish kind of shape with some nondescript lumps in it, and the whole body was just completely unfinished. I had put a new top on it and poured a little resin to stabilize some really rotten knots. So in this video, what we're going to do is I am going to go out and take all those nondescript bumps and turn them into something recognizable. And we'll do a little bit more carving, and then I'm going to paint. And then we'll get to some resin pouring. I haven't done too many resin pouring videos, so you're gonna have to forgive that I just don't know how to get that like super sexy, like resin, slow-mo, B-roll craziness. I'm just gonna pour a bunch of little cups of resin in there. Anyway, without further ado, let's get to it. Okay, so first things first, I have to do a little bit of sketching to kind of figure out where I want things to lay and how I want them to look. And then I need to kind of darken up the areas that I definitely want to remove. I'm not sure how noticeable it is, but I'm using the kind of random shape that I left behind to inspire what I'm gonna draw. Of course, we can't get by without sharpening up, right? Alright, so what I'm doing here is I am walking my chisel around the outside edge of where I'm wanting to carve to separate the fibers wherever I'm going to be, you know, hogging out a bunch of material. Alright, so here you see me breaking out my hammer. Now, although this maple is beetle-ridden, it's still pretty hard. And one thing about carving wood is that, you know, you need to have control of your chisel. Like, if it just breaks loose and slides off, you can really damage something that you spend a lot of time working on. So, you break out the hammer, not so much for the power of it, you know, to be able to dig the chisel in super deep, but You break out the hammer to dictate how far you go, because you can push and you may, you know, push way out, but if you tap it with a hammer, it's going to go the same distance every time you tap it. So it's more of a control thing.
So carving this piece took hours, like literally hours. And so if I were to show you every minute of the work that I did, I mean, this would be an insanely long video, even with it sped up eightfold. So this is kind of an abbreviated version. I'm just showing what I did on the bottom end. I'm not gonna show you a lot about what I did on the top end because it's really just the same thing that I did down here. Okay, so after I was done roughing everything out with a chisel, I came in and cleaned some things up with my Dremel tool in a series of different bits. All right, so we're really gonna add some depth to the carving by just covering it entirely in black paint. I mean, every little nook and cranny needs to have black paint in it. And with this dark base coat, we'll really be able to make all the depth and the different layers stand out when we come back through with other colors on top of it. So this part here is kind of fun. The way I'm going to paint this is I am going to just lightly brush across the high points of my carving with a semi-dry brush and two different tones of gray. And what it does is like the paint just catches on the high points. It doesn't go into all the like little cracks and stuff. So it really accentuates all the carving that was done. It really makes it stand out. And it gives it a ton of depth. So yeah, that's the paint. Now, I didn't go with something incredibly detailed as far as the paint goes because I have this first layer of resin that I'm pouring right now. It's real like murky and gray. I actually had to use tattoo ink to mix into the resin because there isn't actually a transparent gray color pigment for resin. I mean, who knew? After I got that layer down, I started pouring clear stuff on top of it, and I got what looks like deep, murky water, and that is exactly what I was looking for. Okay, now that we have that done, let's take a look at this fretboard. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of rough and ooh, ow, wow, that's bad. Okay, so I've seen a bunch of people on YouTube heating up the frets before they take them out. So I put a notch in my lining tool for my wood burning tool, and yeah, I heated it up, and then I tried pulling it out. It was kind of tough to get up underneath the fret to get a good hold on it, but this is how it went. This is real time, and then I'll speed it up for the rest of the fretboard. So literally the next fret, I tried to do it without heating it up, and it went a lot easier. It went so much faster, and I decided that I wasn't going to heat up any more of them. So as you'll be able to see, the first couple frets have a little bit more tear out than, you know, the ones after that. It's a learning experience for me.
All right, so that's how we got to this point right here. I still have to sand the whole thing down so it's all level. The resin's a little bit lower than the top is. It's really not that bad. Most of the difference is actually a little bit of when the resin cures, it catches on inconsistencies in the edge of things and makes kind of like gnarly little bumpy areas that almost look like bubbles, but it's not. So I have to sand the whole face down to be level, and then I'm going to do some fun things with the body. I'm going to finalize the body shape. This is not going to be the final body shape at all. I just needed to get this resin in here and get all that situated before I could go and cut into things. Because what I did was I had routed out the channel so that I had these edges right here on these three sides so that I didn't have to deal with making reservoirs and dams and stuff for the resin to sit in, and dealing with it spilling everywhere and whatnot. This is just an easier way to do it, since this wasn't the shape that I had intended it to be in the first place. So I have a lot to do on that front. I also have a ton to do on the neck and fretboard. As you saw, I had removed the frets, and so I'm going to replace them with some stainless steel ones, which I think is going to be fun. I don't know. I've never done it before. I'll find out. Anyway, I also have to remove the finish on the neck because it was just too dinged up. I wanted to leave the black, but I can't get away with it. I can't. I also have to put some binding on the fretboard as well. So I have a lot of work to do on that, and the majority of the next video, after I finalize the shape on this, is going to be the neck. I have to strip it, I have to do what I just talked about, and then I also have to take care of the headstock. So I have some fun plans for that as well. Anyway, since you made it this far into the video, please like and subscribe if you haven't already, and go ahead and comment, tell me what you think. I'm hoping to do something cool with this. I know it's coming along kind of slow. A lot of my other guitars are like two videos, and I'm done with them. But I'm trying to be a little bit more comprehensive with this one. So I hope you like the video, and we'll see you next time. Take it easy. Take care.